Oh, there's a lot of news on the Hunter Biden front. He's got a new book out. I'm sure you've already picked it up and read through it, and it's very honest and tell all from the source himself, Hunter Biden. And he's been doing a little bit of a book tour, making the rounds. I still don't comprehend why he's doing this. I mean, if I'm Hunter Biden, I'm never going on camera again. I'm just going to hide and hope everyone forgets about me. But Hunter has a different plan. He went on Jimmy Kimmel and talked about his little rendezvous over there in the Ukraine.
I do want to talk about this, you know, the Ukraine and how it became an issue. It became something, it gave Donald Trump something to grab onto. Yeah. He almost got, well, he did get impeached as a result of it. But you wrote, did I make a mistake by taking a seat on the board of a Ukrainian gas company? No. Did I display a lack of judgment? No. Would I do it again? No.
Yeah, and I meant what I said. I meant what I wrote. Is that, you know, go to the beginning. Is that, you know, I went to Yale Law School. I served on at least a dozen boards before Burisma. I was a vice chairman of the board of Amtrak. I was the chairman of the board of the World Food Program U.S., supporting the largest humanitarian organization in the world. I had expertise in corporate governance. I was asked to serve on the board for corporate governance. Mm. And I was a lawyer at Boies Schiller and Flexner, which was how I was first approached. However, what I didn't take into account was the way in which they would use the perception against my dad. For that, I wouldn't do it again for that reason.
Mm, yeah, and I love how he's like, I had a lot of personal accomplishments. I was on the board of Amtrak. You mean the thing your dad talks about all the time? That's your evidence. Amazing. Yes, he basically, this is the thing where you kind of do this thing where you're like, well, do I have any regrets over that scandal? Yes, I wish I explained myself better. That's kind of what he's going to here. Pretty weak. He also talked about the laptop scandal. Now, remember, this was a big thing right before the election. The media basically did a complete freeze on this at the time. Here's Hunter on his laptop.
I've seen you on some interviews and, you know, talking about the laptop. This became this big thing, the laptop. And when they ask you if that was your laptop, you say you don't know, which is hard to believe unless you read the book.
Yeah.
And then it's kind of like, I'm surprised you have shoes on.
Yeah.
You know?
You know,
I made it. I made it today.
Pants were the problem.
Yeah. Pants are always the problem,
always
really.
The problem. Yeah. No, you know, look, I really don't know. And the fact of the matter is it's a red herring. It is absolutely red herring. But I am absolutely, I think, within my rights to question anything that comes from the desk of Rudy Giuliani. And so I don't know is the answer.
I mean, frankly, that's a fair point in some ways. Like, yes, he's a political opponent. You'd think maybe, I think everybody thought, I don't know, is this real? But when he wouldn't say it wasn't his laptop, it's hard to count it out. And then all the details, the pictures, the texts, everything, it's really impossible to imagine that it's not his laptop at this point. And the Daily Mail seems to have it. They seem to have the laptop or a copy of the hard drive. They have a new story out. It's called Exclusive, What Wasn't in Hunter Biden's Book, How He Got Unauthorized Secret Service Protection, Begged Joe to Run for the White House to Salvage His Own Reputation, and Made Porn Films with Prostitutes. Not exactly the headline you would want. He also says he... There you go. By the way, there's a dog on the bed as they're making the porn films. That's always a good maneuver. So you see pictures like that. They're salacious, sure. It's kind of understandable. And there's other kind of salacious stuff that's been making the rounds a lot on social media. For example, real drug problem for Hunter, as you may know. He seems to have the meth mouth going. Do we have the picture of him at the dentist? Now, that is just... unfortunate. It just does not. His teeth do not look good. He looks like he's got a bunch of Tic Tacs stuck in his gums. That is not a good look. and it was weird because he was really like there was a strange dentist thing that went on. There's a lot of text here. I can't give you all of it. There's so much in this story. Honestly, go to the Daily Mail and check it out. I don't think anyone's even questioning whether this is real at this point. He had a back and forth with his dad on the topic of the dentist. Joe Biden says, do you want me to do anything about Maisie's dentist bill? That's his granddaughter. I was supposed to be paid yesterday, says Hunter, but Eric is holding the check in one of my accounts that he has access to as leverage to have me agree to some demand he has. Also, the first I was told about the bill was an hour before she went into surgery. Of the money I did earn last month, 80% went to Kathleen and the rest mainly the girls. Loving father here. Hunter goes on, so I'll pay it when I have money to pay it. But I think you guys are unreasonably scared of Kathleen. She's done the worst she can do with no pushback from anyone. And despite everyone's impression, I'm far from incapable of handling this. I'll pay you back, the IRS and the girls and the rest of the bills going forward. I was 26 days late on alimony once and only once. It won't happen again. If you've ever had someone who's going through real problems, whether it's like mental illness or drug addiction or something like this, this looks all too familiar to you. I mean, this is like rambling texts, bizarre stories, telling everybody all sorts of stuff. Who knows what's true? Who knows what's not true? And Joe actually comes off in some ways kind of like a sad but loving dad. He says, you need not pay me back. What do you want me to do? Pay the dentist? Anything else? Can you give me an address so I can forward your mail? I'm reluctant to open it, but it has life insurance. Let me know. I love you. Do you want me to open up your business mail or send it? I need an address? On and on and on and on this goes. And you kind of get the sense that really Joe realizes how bad his son is and what kind of position he's in. And Hunter comes off as really a douche throughout this entire period. Now, look, Joe Biden entering into corrupt arrangements to protect his son from his terrible activities is still a crime if he did it. And it's still highly questionable, even if it is technically above board. But remember, this isn't really a story as much about Joe Biden and Hunter Biden right now. We need to dig a little deeper into that, of course. But the media would not let this story be told. We now know it's basically true, right? We've seen the laptop. We've seen all the pictures of him with the prostitutes. We are there. And you look down the road here. Remember in your rearview mirror a little bit right before the election? Here's something Drew Holden, of course, put together a great thread on this. You should always follow Drew because he's always got the goods. The CBS news director reprimanded a reporter for asking Joe Biden a tough question about it. I mean, seriously? We go on, MSNBC. Drew says, I almost appreciate the hustle from MSNBC, who's continued to go to bat for Hunter throughout all of this, even if their tone has changed, well, a touch. It used to be Hunter Biden's story on an obvious Russian plot. Now it's, we know very little at this point. Oh, of course. CNN. To me, this is just classic textbook Russian tradecraft at work. Now it's Justin, President-elect Joe Biden's son, Hunter Biden, says he's facing a tax investigation by the U.S. Attorney's Office in Delaware, which is a known conservative hotspot that the district attorney's office in Delaware on the Biden family. I mean, can you get a more conservative outlet than that? The NPR was probably the worst on this. NPR tweeted this. Why haven't you seen any stories from NPR about the New York Post's Hunter Biden story? Read more in this week's newsletter. And the newsletter said, we don't want to waste our time on stories that are not really stories. And we don't want to waste the listeners and readers' time on stories that are just pure distractions. Well, I mean, obviously, that wasn't true. I mean, there was a lot to this story. It was absolutely true. If you want to talk about media organizations, NPR probably the most guilty, though. There was a lot of guilt all over the place. Twitter, though, set a news standard. Twitter actually said this. They said, our policies are living documents. We're willing to update and adjust them when we encounter new scenarios or receive important feedback from the public. One such example is the recent change to our hacked materials policy and its impact on accounts like the New York Post. What was the account? What was the impact on that account? They banned them in the middle of an election. The oldest newspaper in the United States was banned from Twitter for writing the story, which we now know was true. They might not have liked the impact, but they actually were telling people the link was unsafe. Don't click on this New York Post story. It might be unsafe. Jack eventually, from Twitter, came out and said, our communication around our actions on the New York Post was not great, and we shouldn't have blocked the URL as to zero context as to why we were blocking. It was unacceptable. But, you know, it was a little too little too late. This is the middle of the election, and now they're going to admit that this story was true when it could have made an impact on a very close election. To the point of, like, now people like Chris Hayes are waking up and saying, oh, wait a minute, was this true the whole time? He tweets, so, like, did we ever find out the actual deal with the Hunter laptop? I mean, maybe the wildly improbably story about it was .. true? Or maybe it was a cover story for a hack. But do we know? It's a great question, Chris. Do we know? Do we care to know? It seems like right now the media is finally giving us a little bit of an investigation as to what actually happened with this laptop. But they did something intentional here, and that's what's most important. When the election was on the line, they made a decision to be activists instead of journalists. They said it's more important for Donald Trump to be out of office than for us to maintain our journalistic principles. They didn't care. The entire media jammed this story into the dirt and left only the New York Post to write about it. And then, even then, they wouldn't even let them tweet their own freaking links to the story. It's absolutely embarrassing. And there needs to be people who are held accountable for this. Hi, Stu Burguiere of Stu Does America here. Thanks so much for watching our video. Did you know you can watch our entire catalog for free right here on our channel? Subscribe now and be sure to hit the thumbs up button on all the episodes you watch, because that's how they know you like this stupid show. And that little bell in the corner as well, make sure you click that. You'll get notifications every time we post new content. Stu Does America, every weekday at 8 p.m. Eastern, right here.